Kevin Garnett, the kid, player of the present and future, ideal player of the 21st century. What up?
We call him KG the kid.
KG.
But if you seen him with a basketball, you know that he grown.
Uh-huh.
If you seen him on the ball court, you know that he home.
Right,
it's like every dunk is drastic.
Woo.
First to get drafted out of high school since Moses Malone. Everybody gotta earn their turns.
Uh-huh.
I think the kid game got hotter since his jersey burned. And you couldn't find a finer kid.
Uh-uh.
Then the 7-foot South Carolina kid obsessed with balls.
Obsessed.
And the rim need a hard net.
Hard net.
Better act like you know. Come on, dog. That's Kevin Garnett.
KG.
About to get an and-one all in your mug.
And
said he
one.
Play around the clock cause it's boiling his blood. He ain't think about a turnover.
Uh-uh.
That's KG. He the player of the future. And the game about the turnover.
Yeah.
Think you got game, then you gon' have to learn over.
Yeah.
KG.
The NBA playoffs on TNT are brought to you by the AT&T Ultimate Fan Zone on NBA.com. You can get NBA gear just by talking on the phone. By Heineken, it's all about the beer. Heineken. By Hyundai, where the freedom of America's best warranty is standard equipment. And by Wendy's new garden sensations, we've raised the bar on salads.
Coming up next on TNT, Inside the NBA, presented by Hyundai. The Sacramento Kings are in the Western Conference Finals. We've got the highlights. You're going to hear what they're saying in the locker rooms and at the podium. Kenny Smith, Peter Vesey, Chris Mullin, all here to break down the clincher. Inside is next.
I think about Jess every day.
He used to call me, like, every 10 seconds.
I'd have to use my cell phone.
It's staticky.
We lose calls all the time, which wasn't great for long-distance romance.
So I signed up for AT&T Unlimited.
You can talk to any AT&T residential long-distance customer as long as you want for just $19.95 a month.
It's like we're right next to each other.
I've never had a relationship this long before. It's perfect.
I'm excited. He's excited. I mean, I would hope to think that I'd marry him. But I'm just taking it day by day.
Call 1-800-REACH-OUT.
There is a place where nothing you do is ordinary. Even when all you're doing is pumping gas. When you cross into the blue, everything is different and important.
Especially you.
Brown makes work easy. Brown helps me get it done. Brown keeps track of my addresses. Brown tells people their shipments are coming. Brown even prints the labels for me. Brown takes care of me. I love Brown.
Desktop shipping made easy. What can Brown do for you?
Well, as an older car, even though I've got a couple of scratches, it's nice to have the scratches clean. But, you know, every part of me has to be clean. And part of that is the inner workings of my my engine. But Chevron with Techron helps clean me and keep my emissions low, which is real important in my line of work, being a car.
No gasoline cleans your engine better than Chevron with Techron. In war.
Gentlemen, I intend to put you in harm's way.
You fight with honor, with courage, and with everything you have.
Archangel is down, and I am on the run.
He made it survive, and we will bring you home.
Behind enemy lines, it's heart-pounding action that pushes DVD to the limit.
I'm not gonna let that kid die out there.
You will lose your command.
So be it. Let's go get our boy back.
Behind enemy lines. Own the DVD or rent the video today.
You were my first explosion, turned out to be corrosion. You were the first for me, but you turned me out.
You dropped the bomb on me, baby. You dropped the bomb on me.
Oh, baby.
You dropped the bomb on me, baby. You dropped the bomb on me.
I won't forget what you've done
you
to me.
You dropped the bomb on me, baby. You dropped the bomb on me.
We welcome you to Inside the NBA, presented by Hyundai from Studio A in Atlanta. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Peter Vesey, Chris Mullen.
The Viper.
The Kings are in the Western Conference Finals, 114-101 over the Dallas Mavericks. Who'd have thunk they'd beat these guys in five? We'll talk to these guys about the series in a second, but first, let's go back to Arco Arena. Craig Sager standing by with the owners of the Sacramento Kings. Sags.
Well, it's definitely a team effort. I have the owners, Joe Gavin and Philip Maloof, and since it's Mother's Day, they have their mother, Colleen, here as well. First of all, tell me about the experience of hearing that crowd, the fact that you beat the team, and now you go to the conference finals.
Unbelievable. You know, the fans here deserve it. They've been through 15 years of tough times, and to win it here on our home court like this, it's magnificent.
Dallas takes over home court advantage a week ago, Gavin. What were your thoughts then, and what are they now?
Well, they have a great organization. Mark Cuban's done a terrific job with that team. Turned it around. They have a lot of firepower. They're a scary team. I mean, they're an awesome team. And as you saw tonight, they can come back at any time. But we just wanted to keep our poise, keep battling back, and hopefully get a victory there.
Well, you and your husband owned the Houston Rockets for a while. How proud are you of your sons?
Very proud. They've done a tremendous job and in a short time, in a short period of time. So I'm very happy tonight. And it will continue.
Philip, so many different pieces of this puzzle, but what was the biggest thing? The re-signing of Chris Webber, the free agency of Vlade Divac, what was it?
I think it was a combination of everything, from the ownership to the coach, to Webber, to Hedo, to Bibby, signing Bibby this year, or acquiring Bibby. It's just been a combination of things, and I knew we'd get here one day.
All right, the locker room's open. It means you guys can go in there as well. We'll join you in a moment, but let's go back to the studios and Ernie Johnson.
All right, thank you very much, Segs, and I promise we are going to hear from Peter and Kenny and Chris, but first we're going to hear from Rick Adelman.
It gave us the opportunity to keep him on Nowitzki, so that was really the reasoning. I really was hoping he would get off, and he did.
Rick, coming in, a lot of people were talking about the big advantage Dallas had in the backcourt, but yet you guys seemed to really step up to the occasion. How big of a factor was that in the end?
I think it was huge. I mean, there's no doubt about it. Mike Bibby was just solid. I mean, you don't play any better than that in a big playoff series. And for Bobby Jackson to step in like he did the last two games, you can't say enough about those two guys, you know. And I think everybody did think they had the advantage on us, but I think Bobby and Mike took that on as a challenge. They know they're pretty good players, too, and they wanted to go after them.
Coach Jay Harper with the Davis Enterprise. Can you just talk about, it seems like like you were saying earlier, it's just such a team effort, and there at the end, those guys were all banding together as a team. Do you feel like any string you pull is just going to work at this point right now?
I don't know. I guess I've got a lot of respect and faith in these guys, and they've responded so much last year, but then this year was just unbelievable the way they responded. They're a resilient group. They're a competitive group. I've said it time and time again. I always thought it was funny when people doubted them. You know, like they just respond too much. And I have, like I said, I got great faith in them. And no matter who went down, we felt we could win if we just stayed together. And I think that was the whole key. We stayed together, and you need guys to step up, and we certainly had guys step up.
114-101, the final. Proud night for Rick Adelman, his players, and Peter, the ownership of the Sacramento Kings.
Yeah, I mean, they mentioned the father, George Maloof. He owned the Rockets in the early 80s. In fact, Del Harris was his head coach, and he's the assistant coach of the Mavericks now. And they went to the finals, I believe, in 81. As I recall, and for these guys to be in the league, they were trying to get back into the league for a number of years. They tried to buy the Nets at one time, several other franchises, and boy, they're great owners because they're letting the guy, Jeff Petrie, do exactly what he wants to do.
We will get to Kenny and Chris in just a second, I promise. Vlade Divac in the locker room. Believe me, Kenny, we'll get to you.
Well, it's hard to say. You know,
well, talking about Vlade Divac, one of the six players in double figures tonight for the Sacramento Kings, now in his fourth year with the Kings. Vlade, what was the difference in this team compared to a year ago? Why do you win these games that a year ago you couldn't?
Well, we grew up. You know, I think we grew from last 3 years making playoffs. We know exactly how to play now, important games. And we built something special here the last 4 years, so we just want to make sure that we move on.
You're the first one here. You came here. Did you ever imagine something like this could happen in Sacramento?
Well, when I came here 4 years ago, you can't do worse than what they did in the past. So everything that we did, you know, it's great. You know, I believed in Jeff that's going to make a team of the good players here. So it's a special feeling right now.
You're known as the godfather of this team. You take everybody underneath your wing, particularly Hito Turkoglu. Talk about his game tonight.
Well, he was great. I mean, he was big in the second half. We knew they're going to make runs on us, but he took over in the second half.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Let's go back to the studio.
Thank you very much, Craig. And you take a look at the AOL brackets. The Kings are through to the Western Conference Finals to meet the winner of the Lakers and Spurs series, which resumes tomorrow night, game two of our doubleheader on TBS. Now, Chris, we don't know at this point who that's going to be. We may have a decent idea with the Lakers leading that 3-1. But take me through what the Kings have done now, kind of a slow-it-down blanket the Jazz threw at him, and then more of an up-tempo, more of a Sacramento style against Dallas. What is next if you're the Sacramento Kings, and how are you feeling right now?
Well, I think they feel great. They had got a total team effort, not only in this game, but throughout the whole playoffs, you know. And like Rick said, he said they respond to every question mark. I think they've taken huge steps to this point. Like you said, Utah gave them a little trouble. They took care of that. Second round here with Dallas, they had the injury to Peja Stojakovic, who we didn't even talk about. Right. But the reason being is Turkoglu and Bobby Jackson play so well. So if he gets healed up, I think it's going to be a great series. And now they can bring, you know, the home court, which they worked all year for. They got that. I think it's going to be a great series.
It's only happened six times that a team down 3-1 comes back to win. It has not happened here once again, but Kenny Smith is here to tell you it can be done because his Rockets did it in 95.
Not only being down 3-1, but also been on two teams that was down 0-2, losing the first two games at home. So the first thing, I believe, if you want to be successful to have it, you got to have a beast. You have to have somebody who can really take over the game, and that's what we had in Hakeem Olajuwon. But the other thing is the way you lose the games. You have to be in control of the games that you've lost. And then you have a belief in yourself to say, you know what? They're not really beating us. We're beating ourselves. They can't beat us. So you have to have that belief only by being in control in those games.
I want to talk about that in terms of San Antonio and the Lakers, but let's do that after we come back in our next segment. Is that a deal?
I'll put the lip
Wonderful.
Lock on.
Coming up next.
Lip lock.
What they're saying before Game 5 in the Spurs-Lakers series, which could be the San Antonio swan song. Back with more on Inside right after this.
Inside the NBA on TNT is brought to you by Hyundai, where the freedom of America's best warranty is standard equipment.
Evan.
No, I don't think so, kid.
Wait, I wasn't bad.
Bad wasn't the problem. You were boring, taking up space. You should have gotten the new Hyundai Tiburon.
Nice, huh? It's got 6-speed transmission, V6 power, and the freedom of America's best warranty plan.
Can I drive?
This is hell, kid. You get the minivan.
No!
A set of Goodyear tires. I want some Goodyear tires.
Okay, honey.
Did you just move the blimp?
No.
At Sears Auto Center, all Goodyear tires are 10 to 30% off, so you can get exactly what you want at the lowest prices of the season. Sears, where else?
TNT's hit original drama returns with a special two-hour season premiere.
Please hold it!
All units, shots fired!
She's got battle skills that are supernatural.
This June, New York's toughest cop is back. See the two-hour season premiere, Witchblade, Sunday, June 16th at 8, only on TNT.
Welcome back to Inside. Not only is it Kayla Smith's 9th birthday, Kenny's daughter, it's also Mike Bibby's 24th birthday. It is not Scott Pollard's birthday. That was February 12th. At any rate, he is standing by with Craig Sager.
Whoa!
Well, it's not his birthday, but it's always a party with Scott Pollard. Talk a little bit about the series here and how you guys feel about eliminating Dallas, which could have been a tough team, especially after they stole the home court last weekend.
Well, they did steal the home court, but we went in and stole it back at their place. We feel really good about coming in against a team that had their back against the wall, and we took care of business tonight in game four and got it over with, so we don't have to go back to Dallas.
Your coach said it was a matchup difficulty playing Scott Pollard in the pick and rolls, yet every time you went in during the series, you were very productive. How tough is it not to get a lot of playing time, and how do you keep your mental focus?
Well, I've been coming off the bench for most of my career, so I'm just used to, you got to be ready when the coach comes down and calls you up. You got to be ready to go in and do your thing, and sometimes you are and sometimes you're not. Most of the time I'm ready, and fortunately for myself, this series, when I was called on, I was ready to go.
Every team in the NBA has talented players, yet it takes a special group like this to advance. 6 players in double figures. Why is the chemistry so great in this team?
Well, we all genuinely respect each other and like each other as people. We get along very well. There's no egos that are too high that we can't just joke with a guy from Chris Webber on down. We all make fun of each other and get along, and on the plane, it's pretty loud on almost every plane trip.
It gives you guys a chance to rest since the Lakers are still playing against San Antonio. What does Scott Pollard do when everybody's supposed to be resting?
Scott Pollard rests too. I'm gonna go back home. We get to stay home. We don't have to fly anywhere for the next round. So I'm gonna stay at my house and hang out with my family for a little bit. And when it's time to go into work, I'll be in at work getting things done.
And then think about possibly LA and Shaq.
Whoever it is, we'll be ready. And they gotta come to our place.
All right, thanks a lot. Let's go back to Ernie.
All right, thank you, Segs. And Scott, meantime, for the Mavericks, who lost in 5 to the Spurs in the conference semis last year, they lose in 5 this time to the Kings. Here's Nelly.
You know, who played. I mean, you could name anybody of their top 6-7 guys and say, boy, those guys really came to play and did a great job. And they did every night. They really came and they brought it to us. And they should really be proud of their team.
Coach Scott Marsh, Kings Radio. You talk about the Kings being a little bit further along the learning process in the playoffs. Do you think they're far enough along to win a championship this year?
Is this team, you mean the Kings?
Are they championship?
Not us, we got eliminated.
Right, I'm talking about the Kings, yeah.
Okay. you know, I hope so. I'm really rooting for them because I love the style of basketball they play, and I think the coaching staff here is grossly underrated. I really wish them the best. Can they beat the Lakers or, you know, San Antonio? I don't know, but man, I'm rooting for them. Because you know what? If they can, maybe we can. Someday.
Nelly, what was the difference for Dirk Nowitzki tonight, and how encouraging was it to see him?
Difference from who?
For Dirk Nowitzki tonight, as opposed to the other games he's through the score. And what?
Oh. You know, it's. You're talking about so many minor things, you know, that can go right or wrong in a game that changes his mind. I think his energy level was better. I think he tried to do a couple of things that helped his offensive game, was to pass early and swing the ball. And then, you know, once you start doing that, then his game opens up. Then he was very aggressive and just started getting it going. But, you know, he's got a lot of growth to go at this point. And we love him to death, but he's got another step to go before we can consider him a superstar. And that's his passing skills. It's pretty simple. He'll get it. I can't wait to start working with him on that's the last thing. Other questions, or am I out of here?
You're out of here.
Back to Maui.
He is, as a matter of fact. And meantime, when Scott Pollard was talking to Segs, the word chemistry came up. Kenny immediately said, I want to talk about that. What you got?
Because chemistry is a word that you never can put a finger on. You can never say that this is the thing that could say that this team has chemistry and they play well together, maybe because they hang out well on the court. Certain teams didn't, but that I was played with that didn't hang out after the game. But we still had great chemistry. But when you see it, you know it's there. And Funderburk. Lawrence Funderburk was a guy that showed me that this team has chemistry, because here's a guy who did not play one single minute, but is excited more than anyone else about winning the series. So that showed me right there that team has chemistry, because that's the things that you look for. Guys who are unselfish even when it's a time they could be selfish.
That reminded you of yourself when you were cheering for Cassell in that championship.
You know, no question. You have to be unselfish because there are certain players that help get you there.
Kenny, don't play straight. Don't play it straight, please.
No question. Hey, on the Dallas side of things, now, what do they have to do to take that next step, Chris?
I think Nelly hit it on the head. He knows what he's doing, and I think some of his players are young as far as playoff experience. Nowitzki's going to get better. He's great already, but he's going to work on his passing skills, passing out of double teams, so he can become a better post-up player and make people pay. The other thing, piggybacking on Kenny, is I play with Chris Webber, and, you know, the big thing is when your best player is your best practice player is a huge thing. But Chris Webber is also a great teammate. He embraces everybody. You know, I mean, he includes everybody, and he's just a wonderful teammate. And I think that's what Paolo was talking about. They can joke with him as well as they can joke with, you know, the 12th guy on the team. I think that a lot of that is credit to Chris Webber's personality.
Back on the Dallas side of things, Nick Van Exel struggled in the last three games. In Game 3, 3-for-11. In Game 4, 2-for-10. And tonight, he was going 1-for-7 going to the fourth quarter. Do I have his final numbers here? Check it out. And he was 3-for-9 tonight. Moments ago, he talked to Craig Sager.
Yeah, they can continue to make big shots. And the hustle plays, they continue to get. And, you know, throughout the series, they got too many easy buckets. And, you know, they sort of exploited us on, you know, our pick and roll coverage, our pick and roll defense, and they flat out won the series.
I think it was hard to get a string of stops together, wasn't it?
It was hard to get a string of stops the whole series. You know, they're a pretty good offensive team, and just really made our defense look real bad.
Is it a case of them just being really good and pretty deep as well?
You could say that, but I think we're just as deep as they are. You know, we didn't play good defense throughout the series. That's the bottom line. We shot 47%, didn't play good defense. And, you know, you can look at the last three games we've lost. Our defense, you know, in the playoffs, the way they scored a lot of those easy buckets, guys, just a lot of layups. It's tough to win, especially against a team like that.
Okay, Pete, next step for the Mavs.
Yeah, I mean, Mark Cuban tried to buy chemistry when he got Van Exel and Rafe LaFrenz. He thought perhaps he was getting a shot-blocking defensive player in LaFrenz, but they've got some huge decisions to make right now. You know, they've got to get better. Their flaws have been exposed. Talking about defense, they need a gladiator in that middle or power forward to compensate, to help Nowitzki and Nash with their lack of defense. So the only way they can do that is to trade Finley and Van Exel. You know, whether they can put those two together or Finley with somebody else and trade them, it's going to be very difficult because most teams don't like to trade big for small unless you're dealing with Wes Unseld.
There you go. I leave that one up. That's right up that. To you. 114-101, the Sacramento Kings winners over the Dallas Mavericks, who are eliminated in five. Back with more on Inside right after this.
Express pickup. Wow, what a time saver, Ted. I mean, order stuff online, pick it up right away, and you're gone. Honey, you could have waited.